Hello everyone, my name is LeFrancois and today I'm going to show you some creative uses of VoiceMeeter that you can utilize during your StreamYard broadcast. If you haven't already, we've done a video on the setup of VoiceMeeter for streaming. You'll want to make sure you watch that video. The link to that is in the description below. The reason you need to watch that video is because this video will be a video that you can watch after you have set up VoiceMeeter, as we'll talk about some creative stuff you can do with the application after you already have it set up. So you want to make sure that you have VoiceMeeter set up prior to watching this video. With that being said, we're going to jump right into this one. All right, so the first thing I want to talk about are all of the options available for the inputs on VoiceMeeter. If you followed our VoiceMeeter setup guide on this channel, you most likely have your microphone set up on the hardware input one. In the hardware inputs, we have what is called the intellipan. The first option on the intellipan is a color panel. The color panel is an EQ for that input. So if I were to click on this dot here and drag it over to the left, it will add some bass or low frequency to my vocals. If I were to bring it to the right, it will actually bring some mids to my vocals. And then if I raise it up just below that line there, it will bring in some highs into my vocals. Now, if I go past that line, it will bring in an echo, which will create kind of a brightness effect to your voice. Most people really like to have their vocals sitting right here, a little bit into the lows and a little bit up on the highs, just to increase that lower part of your vocals. Now, if you right click on this panel, it will bring up a modulation panel or an FX panel. In this panel, you can create some warping sounds to your voice. So if you want to get creative with your stream, add some robotic-y kind of sounds or whatever, you can go to the modulation panel. And this is what it sounds like. Testing the modulation panel, testing the modulation panel, and testing the modulation panel. What you'll notice is on that left side of the panel, it has more of a lower kind of warping, a lower frequency to the warping. And on the right side, it has more of a higher frequency where it will warp it very quickly. Now, if you right click it again, you have a 3D panel. This will adjust where that audio is coming from. So if you want to sound like you're coming from a very far distance, you can drag this all the way up. Now, if you want to sound like you're coming from the right side, you can do so by bringing that dot to the right, and same with the left. And you can do any variation of that by dragging it across this panel. Now, if you double click with your left mouse, it will reset that, and you can right click and it will bring you back to the color panel. Below the color panel, we have two options in the audibility. You have a compression on the left side and you have a noise gate on the right side. If you have any unwanted background noise, say like fan noise, air noise, any kind of airy kind of noise that is being picked up by your microphone, you can try cutting those out by raising the noise gate. The noise gate will raise the floor volume of your microphone, meaning instead of your microphone coming in with its signal down here, it will do so from up here. The problem is if you raise this too high, you'll end up cutting off some of your voice, and that is damaging your vocals. So you don't want to raise it too high, but you want to raise it just high enough to cut out anything that you don't want coming in on your microphone. But be aware that sometimes you can't eliminate, you know, everything using a noise gate filter. So on the left side of that is a compression filter. A compressor filter is going to compress the dynamic range of an audio signal. Just to make it very simple for you guys, it will bring up the lower volumes of an audio signal and it will squash down the higher volumes of an audio signal. This compressor has an auto makeup gain, which means it increases the volume as well when you turn the compressor on. So if you turn the compressor on, you want to make sure you also decrease the volume. So if I turn this compression on, you'll notice I start to get louder. I want to make sure I compensate by decreasing the volume on this slider. The last thing I wanted to show you guys is the EQ available on VoiceMeeter. The EQ is a very powerful tool that will help you optimize the overall sound quality of your microphone when streaming on StreamYard. If you followed along with our VoiceMeeter setup guide, that means you've set up your microphone to be sent to the B2 source or the VoiceMeeter aux output on VoiceMeeter. This source here is displayed in the master section. It is a virtual output, and what you can see here is the B2 source with the analyzer of the sound going up and down. That is where we're sending our microphone audio. Now, to turn on the EQ, we simply click on the EQ button, and then we can right click and enter into that EQ panel. This EQ allows us to adjust or make adjustments to specific frequency ranges in the audio signal. So if we wanted to add some lows to our voice, we could increase the 200 frequency hertz range by increasing that decibel dial there. Now, you can also adjust the width or the thickness of the adjustment by adjusting the Q dial here. You can also move the frequency by adjusting this dial up here. For instance, if you wanted to add some highs to your vocals, you could adjust the 8,000 hertz frequency range. If you wanted to cut out the sibilant sounds, so things like S's from your vocals, you could adjust this dial to the 6,000 hertz range and then do a complete cut of that audio signal to help reduce the S's and those harsh sounds from being picked up on that audio signal. That's going to complete this tutorial, guys. I want to thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more content just like this. If you guys have any questions or you have any ideas as far as how you would utilize VoiceMeeter or your StreamYard broadcast, make sure you leave those in the comment section below. With that being said, guys, I want to thank you again for watching, and I will catch you in our next video. Peace.